part two of the second video that's within the law enforcement tab. What I'm doing and drawing attention to with this video is just how ignorant all of you are in law enforcement in a professional capacity. I'm going to show you how you are so clueless to what is actually going on in this world and how you've all been lied to. I'm just going to use one example. And there's lots of these test cases that I can show you that are proven. First one is the Vegas terrorist attack. 58 people were killed, over 400 people, 414, I believe, were injured. Did you know that not one bullet from the so-called investigation that was done by the Las Vegas Police Department and the FBI, who seems to be around in all of these nefarious acts when they happen, they closed the case just a little while ago. And did anyone bother to read the results, or did you see it reported on here in Canada? Don't think so, because they're not going to show you the truth. Here's the truth of the matter. Not one bullet that came out of so-called Paddock's guns that he fired matched anyone that was killed on the ground. That's the first fact. Second fact, we've got multiple pictures and video, real time, of that hotel room. And there's no fire coming from that hotel room. And here's the part that'll really get all of you, just to show you how corrupt and we've been lied to across the board, especially from mainstream media. One of the top news organizations in the United States first showed the live camera that was on one of the SWAT team guys that breached in that room, the task force team that went into Paddock's room initially when they first got in there. They only released one of them. Well, that was more than enough. Two things were found to be true. We have, and you're seeing, I provided the video right here for you, is you're going to see one of the men walk over and over to the window that Paddock was shooting out of and pull the curtain back. And that window is not broken. And he says that right on the record. It's not broken. How did Paddock shoot all these people? A little bit of a problem there, don't you think? Where are all the shell casings on the ground? He shot thousands of rounds. There should be shell casings all over the ground. There's nothing. When they breached that room that Paddock was in, supposedly, when they knocked the doors and everything all in, if that window had have been broken, you would have seen the drapes fluttering out of that window. You don't see any of that. And here's the part that's really disturbing to show you the trouble that we're all in. The mainstream media cut out, I believe it's about 40 seconds, 20 to 40 seconds of the original video from that man's that he was wearing in that room that day. When you go and see what the people, the population was showed all around the world from that body cam, and then you actually get the original footage, you see that they cut out the 20 or 40 seconds when that officer walks over, pulls the drapes back, and says, "There's no window broken. Paddock didn't shoot anybody. Paddock didn't kill anybody. Not anyone that was down, at least in that festival, and he sure as hell didn't do it from that room." And yet, the FBI and the Las Vegas Police Department have closed their massive investigation that they've undertaken on behalf of the people. And they released a 3-page report. Three. If that doesn't wake law enforcement up right now that we have a serious problem in this world, what's going on? This is what I stated back in September the 15th, 2017, with that channel when I gave an interview. I said it clearly right there. All of these corporations in law enforcement have been corrupted. It's not the people, the majority of the people that are in within law enforcement. It's the very higher ups, the executives within these organizations. They're corrupt to the core, and this is being shown in these Vegas clips. The other one is GC Math. GC Math is a natural drug that an incredible man by the name of David Noakes out of the UK discovered many years ago and brought it forth with a team of doctors, and they saved over 9,000 people with stage 4 cancer. And then the system, you know, these governments that are supposed to represent us, came after them with their crown attorneys again. Many of these people were locked up. A lot of these doctors died in some very, very disturbing ways, but they were all fluffed off as suicides, of course. And now we have left the one man standing. There was a woman that was standing with him, but she's been extradited to France. And now David's being looked to be extradited to France, and he's caused no wrong or harm to anyone. They haven't killed anybody with this GC Math. And this is what our world is not being told. I've known David for about 3.5 years now. I reached out to him with the common law Originally, I also reached out with them to help save a very dear friend of mine. She died because we could not get this GCMAF over into this country because of the UK government and because of the Canadian government watching and blocking anything that comes into this country that surrounds this man. And this man right now needs your help. He needs every man and woman in law enforcement. I don't care if these law enforcements are on the other side of the pond in England. Will somebody in this country, will somebody with the courage, will a group of you not come forward and be on the public record that they are not to extradite this man out of the UK? Because once he goes to France, right now his counterpart, the woman, doctor, she's starving right now in one of the French jails. This woman, they figure, is probably going to be dead before Christmas. She's caused no wrong or harm to anybody. And when you listen to the video clip that I've given you of hearing from David himself, this is something that all of you need to drill down on. These are the foundational truths that are being kept from this world. It's not just our court system. It's not just this enormous unlawful conversion that's happened against all of us when we were born. Yes, these are the foundational ones, but here's a real-time thing that's happening right now. They are trying to extradite David Noakes from the UK. And if they are successful with that, that man is going to wind up dying in a jail. Is this what we do to people that stand up with courage? And his life has been completely destroyed financially in every single aspect. These people wearing the black robes over there are the most evil on this planet. And that's why I am not going to allow a man like David Noakes to stand on his own. And that's why I'm telling the world, you need to rally around this man. We need people in this country in law enforcement. If you've got contacts in the UK, get on the blower to them. Tell them they have to get involved with this. They've got to protect David. Once we bring all of this out into the light, all of this stops. Is it not worth the fact? Do you know how many millions of people are dying every year with cancer? I shouldn't have to tell you this. But oh no, cancer's a business. Cancer's a big business for the medical industry. Because what are they going to do with all these radiation machines that only give you cancer? They don't kill the cancer. They don't cure you. But here we have a man with an 89% cure rate. And it could probably be a lot higher had his development and this truth that he uncovered with GCMAF. It's actually natural within our own bodies. You can't patent it. It's absolutely beautiful what this man brought forward. So here's the truth on cancer, right? There's one of the solutions that are out there that this man is right now in real time being destroyed. And all of you in law enforcement need to step up. All of us in this country and around the world need to step up and bring a very bright light to what is going on with this man and stop it and get the woman out of France, out of that jail, and hold all these people accountable who have acted against this truth and preventing millions of people dying from around the world for an unnecessary disease. And lastly is cannabis, as I put on here. Cannabis is one of the most incredible plants that was put on this earth. Okay, we need to get beyond demonizing it, which you're doing with your attacking all of these dispensaries and that don't have licenses. Let's get something real clear. Unless a man or a woman causes wrong or harm to another man or woman, none of you have any jurisdiction to get involved. It's a private agreement. It's a private contract. Okay? If I go to McDonald's and I get something from McDonald's and I come home and I become deathly ill, that's something that they are liable for at that restaurant. Okay? So we have some very foundational core truths of other serious topics in this world, as I've covered within this website now. And the Vegas shooting, the GCMAF, the cannabis, the 5G, the vaccines, all of this stuff, especially climate change, all of this stuff is fraud and corruption that's occurring around all of these core foundational truths that are going to save our world if we are able to collectively come together and address them. So I require of you, I'm asking every man and woman out there, look at these videos. Look what this man's going through. Look up the truth, okay? Get software that allows you to download YouTube videos onto your computer. Start saving it and start sharing it. You need to share this truth with everybody around this world. And it's only through having this conversation, that's what this is all about. It's a conversation that we all should have had a long time ago, and we're going to correct all of this. But it's not going to happen as long as we remain ignorant, as long as we allow and recognize that our consciousness has been corrupted, and we don't have the courage to come forward and stand in front of our fellow man in the light and say, this is true.